Good morning. I don't know if this is going to work. I'm at church and I'm getting ready to teach Sunday school. And today, yesterday was a great day. Lynn and I ran in the Grey Ghost Run, and I got in a good ride in the morning, and then was able to deliver the camper. But you know, I've been thinking about the whole Dopey thing and how dopey we are. And is the Bible dope? I mean, it was put together by people in an age before science. It kind of lends itself to think there's probably some dopiness in that too. And I know that people say, "Oh, I don't know." Well, I don't know. I mean, faith. My faith does not stem from the Bible being a divine book. I really do feel like I felt Christ's influence in my life in various moments, and it's been very real. Are there dopey parts of the Bible? That's very easy for me to say. I bet there's 40% of it. The Gospels seem quite solid. But I found out today that it was on Facebook, and I don't know if this is true, but that America has the second highest poverty rate for children. I just saw this, and I couldn't help but comment on it. And if that's true, and the way that we talk about how great we are and what a great nation we are and all this stuff, man, that's some dopey stuff is going on. And it's constant. My family wanted me to run a red light this morning to get to church quicker. It's just, and I, believe me, let me say, I've got tons of these dopey moments too, but I think we need to have a little humility about just how seriously dopey we are. And that even the things we study and live by, there's dopiness ingrained, and we need, I don't know, we need a little humility here in the sense of we're losing contact. That, you know, they want teachers to make the United States number one in reading and math. We have the second highest poverty rate, percentage of kids in poverty. Do the math. That's not going to happen. I'm sorry, they're malnourished. I think they're malnourished emotionally even more than food. I think that people with their electronics and having electronic babysitters, kids are just lost. They're just hungry. There is a malnutrition of affection more than food, and then we're going to produce these great minds. They're scratching for what they need. It's not a matter of great minds.